Today we're going to talk about fraction division. I want to start off by dividing a fraction by an integer. I don't know anything about division and fractions, but I do know how to multiply by fractions. So I'm going to take my division problem, turn it into a multiplication problem using our rule for division. Our definition of division tells us that division is just multiplying by a reciprocal. So 3/7 divided by 8 is just 3/7 times the reciprocal of 8. And we know how to multiply fractions. We just multiply the numerators. 3 times 1 is 3. And we multiply the denominator. 7 times 8 is 56. So we divided a fraction by an integer. Let's move on to dividing one fraction by another fraction. Right here we've got 3/5 divided by 4/7. And now we see why it's really good that we have a rule for division, because, you know, what does it mean to take 3/5 of something and divide it up into 4/7 boxes? That doesn't even make any sense. But we have a rule for taking this division and turning it into a multiplication. 3/5 divided by 4/7, that's just 3/5 times the reciprocal of 4/7. What's the reciprocal of 4/7? We'll have to figure that out, and then we'll come back to this. So we want the reciprocal of 4/7. Reciprocal, that means we're going to look for the number that if we multiply 4/7 by our mystery number, we'll get 1. Now I'm going to take a guess here. Now, guessing has a long and glorious history in mathematics. I'm going to guess that my reciprocal is also a fraction. And I know how to multiply two fractions. I multiply their numerators. 4a, I guess 7b on the bottom. And I'm looking for a over b here. I'm looking for a and b such that this product equals 1. I want this fraction over here, 4a over 7b, to equal 1. Now, a fraction equals 1 if its numerator and denominator are the same, because if you take a number, divide that number by itself, you get 1, unless the number is 0. No dividing by 0. So we want to choose a and b here that make the numerator and the denominator the same. And we have a pretty clear choice here. We can't choose 0, no dividing by 0. But we can make a 7, and we make b 4. That makes the top and the bottom will both be a product of 4 and 7. So they'll be the same. Let's check it out. We take 4/7, and we multiply that by 7 over 4. We multiply the tops, we get 4 times 7. We multiply the bottoms, we get 7 times 4. Both the top and the bottom is a product of 7 and 4. It doesn't matter what order we multiply in, we get the same thing. So the numerator and the denominator are the same, so this product is 1. And we found our reciprocal. We find the reciprocal of 4/7, find the reciprocal of any fraction just by taking the fraction and flipping it over. Reciprocal of 4 over 7 is just 7 over 4. Now we can go take care of this problem that we were working on before. 3/5 divided by 4/7 is just 3/5 times the reciprocal of 4/7. And the reciprocal of 4/7, we just flip the fraction over, we've got 7 over 4. And now we've turned our division into a multiplication. We know how to handle multiplication. We multiply the tops, 3 times 7 is 21. Multiply the bottoms, 5 times 4, 20. And we've knocked that off. Let's do one more, make sure we have this down. We will move on to dividing a negative fraction by a positive fraction. Now we already know for our rules for division, if you divide a negative by a positive, you're going to get a negative. We know how to deal with the negative right away. You just take the negative out. This is just going to be negative 2/3 divided by 3/7. And we know how to handle this division now. We're just going to turn it into a multiplication. This will be negative of 2/3 times the reciprocal of 3/7. Reciprocal of a fraction, you just flip it over, times 7/3. And we know how to multiply fractions. You multiply the 2 and the 7, you get 14. You multiply the 3 and the 3 in the denominator, you get 9. And our answer is negative 14 over 9. And we're done.